mother knows me like the piano, and my mother's home.
Essentially, after World War II, Eritrea is given away. From 1960 to 1990, Eritrea and Ethiopia go into a war. During this time, my mother and my father are moving around, not knowing each other up until that point. If you want to call them refugee camps or asylum centers, it's essentially just holding cells for refugees who haven't got their papers together. From when I was born, we were in 3 or 4 different asylum centers.
You would show me that I have something. Some people call us soul.
I think there's a level of empathy now that is just not there. At least from my understanding of Denmark, you know, where we ended up. There is a Samaritan aspect of welcoming migrants. Whereas the whole tendency of what you see in the world right now is very anti-immigration. You don't control where you're born. You see people in Libya now getting stuck and there's essentially a slave trade happening. People are dying, you know, crossing in boats. And I think we push these problems away because you can't deal with that shit on a daily basis. And obviously, you know, it's like, how are you as one person gonna, you know, gonna change this geopolitical landscape, you know? But so it just becomes hella frustrating.
And you know I left, I flew the nest. And you know I'll be alone. And in my chest, you know the best.
I had one teacher who I think the equivalent of it would be somewhere between nigger and negro. You know, it's a thing they only have in Denmark. And she, for some reason, just would not stop saying it. I definitely had those racial experiences. Sometimes, you know, with the older generation, they were taught that these terms were okay. Even when I'm in Denmark sometimes, they like, wow, you speak so good Danish. Are you adopted? Denmark is a fantastic country in many other ways, though. But then again, you know, there's the other side of it being that because that many cultures haven't merged yet, that certain things are backwards, you know? Malcolm in prison, found faith. I listen and find Nate, nigga. I am the wine's grape, me and a divine dame call fate on a blind date, and she will obey. But will you fit in your office, when I slip up out my coffin? I got these fits of voltage. I'm in the light tower getting hit with the euphoria. Like I got the fix to the poison. Blah, 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 in the 808, you boring. Look, I heard your story. The rest of you sound very Aubrey. You're coming to Denmark as the first wave of African immigrants, you know, the first true black people to actually settle in the country. So there was no concept of black culture. When I found hip hop, I found something that I didn't find in sports, which was, you know, the true means of expressing myself. What made me fall in love with hip hop, and especially American hip hop, was the fact that I was seeing black men being so successful. The narrative is for the, you know, the young black man that is disenfranchised, I feel, you know, that's the story that hit me. Don't let them gash you, nigga, I came to play. I'll be disappointed if I don't change the game. Watch me get up, shift up through your rank. I'm fiddling with the nuke, I got this shit talk like Iran. I'm RZA with the woo, I will spit up your whole clan. Who you pitting me against? Watch me shit over your mans. Don't let me get in the trance, I will get over your fence. My city just really took me up, you know, I would start getting gigs, like they start putting me in the papers. I moved straight out of my mother's house, you know, I moved into a big apartment in Copenhagen, and all of a sudden I was playing big festivals. I had done a group album when I was 16, but this was like my own stuff. I got a publishing deal with Warner Chappell, you know, I got some good bread from that, and I was like, you know, I'm not gonna really like stay here, because for you to kind of like get to a big platform, they want you to start doing it in their language, because their concept is, you know, you're Danish, so why are you not doing it in English? And I'm like, what? So now I'm Danish? You know what I mean? I thought I wasn't. So I went to London. I had a good little run there. I felt like, you know, the whole concept was with London was for me to kind of get a little bit of like hair on my chest before I got here. I fell in love. I was in LA. I was kind of like, where am I going to live in America? And yeah, New York just matches my energy. Everyone comes here with a dream and a concept of what they want to do. And while the system in Denmark may be better, the opportunities here are different. Culturally and socially, you know, there's going to be more subcultures. There's going to be more niche because it allows it. Me coming from a small country, this is a playground. Know this nigga in France, I can't wait to whip his ass. I know a bitch in London, I can't wait to get her back. Woo! My mama said I need a nap. I slept up in the lab. This record is my ass. I'm stepping round the ring. I'm setting up the jab. I'm checking out the thing. They betting on your ass? Gosh. But those blessings, they will pass. And fuck a referee. He'll get messed up in the clash. I'm sensing the opening and then I'm getting in that ass. Just like an ad, I'll manipulate you fast. You'll capitulate in ash. You got red up on your flag, the head up on your staff, like that geek back up in class. Woo! It's like a weapon, this whole raft. Got a pen in one hand and the other loaded gap. Nigga, you gotta know to have. All right, man, get that album, The Ascension, out now.